Hi guys, welcome back again to my channel. It's PM Biology and we are continuing the pre-fertilization event structure and events. Okay, so you can refer my last video to go for the topic which is mentioned over here. The I button is there in the right hand side corner of at the top. So you can click on that and you will get the link about the details whatever was taught in the last class. So for today's class we will be talking about microsporangia, how microsporangia is becoming mature and giving rise to your male gametophyte. That is the end of this process, that would be called what? It's a pollen grain. So let's go for it. So see, this is your microspore. So microspore mother cell. I'll be writing in details. For this, too many layers of cells are there, which we talked about. That is what? It's our tapetum cells. Next to it, 2 to 3. Parenchymatose layers are there. Parenchymatose layers, as in my last video I had mentioned it with red marker, same I am continuing with it. So 2 to 3 layers we will be keeping for it. So see, last layers. Parenchymatose cells are of irregular shape, so you can mention it like any shape and size will work for. Next, some radial arrangement of cells were there. What was that called? That was your endothecium. So this is your endothecium cells. I have just magnified the portion of this. Magnified. So radial cells like this, and finally we will be drawing the outermost layer, flag shaped cells. Those are your epidermis. So let's level it. This is epidermis. This layer is endothecium. The red colored is middle layers. Last but very very important, that is tapetum. And inside or at the center, a large cell is there. That is your the most protective layer which the tapetum is protecting, and it's called microspore mother cell. So this is the magnified portion of what? The anther layers. If we take a section of it, if we magnify it, we will be seeing this layers. Now we will be directly going. We know that we have come to an end of the topic, that is MMC. We want microspore mother cell. From here only we will be going to the next step. For this structure is over, we will be going for the event which is taking place, that is microsporogenesis. So now, since we have got this microspore mother cell and where it is present, we know that was the important structure what we studied of anther. Now we can go for this particular topic. What is it? It's microsporogenesis. See, it's micro spore. It has been derived from the word micro spore. Micro means small, or we can say very very small, and spore. For this particular spore, these are acting as gamete cells, which would be helping for fertilization. And genesis, as you all would be knowing, is formation. So how we can define microsporogenesis? A process in which microspore develops from microspore mother cell by meiosis division. So the process of development of a single microspore from microspore mother cell by meiosis is called microsporogenesis. Genesis means formation, and what we are going to get? We are going to get microspore. So microsporogenesis. So now we are going to talk about the steps of microsporogenesis. So what we started from? We need to start from the microspore mother cell. So this microspore mother cell will be going for its first meiotic division. First meiotic division. We know that cell division are of two types, and this meiotic division would be taking place in which cells? In your germinal cells. So there are two types of divisions, mitotic and meiosis. So here we have mentioned about meiotic division. That means meiotic division is taking place where? In the germinal cells. Mitotic division will be taking place in somatic cells. In short, we can say germinal cells means sex cells or gamete formation cells. So meiosis are taking place in germinal cells. So this microspore mother cell undergoes the first meiotic division, and this meiotic division would be giving rise to four haploid structures. Upon differentiation, they will be giving rise to four microspores, that is the end product of this process. See, I have mentioned here these four. Most angiosperms have these structures. All the four can be seen like this. Other arrangement of the MMC after meiotic division can be this. But when we are talking about angiosperms, it is taking place like this. All the four microspores can be seen from forward view. And upon differentiation, no division will be taking place now. Division has already occurred. So it would be giving rise to four haploid cells. Why haploid cells? This is mother cell is diploid in nature, that means it contains whole set of chromosomes, and here we are, the end product which we got are four haploid microspores. That means here the chromosome number has reduced to half. So if we take it as 2n, we are ending up with haploid number of cells, that is n. So now we have got four microspores. Four means we can say tetrad condition. So microspore tetrad. From a single mother cell, we are getting four microspores. four microspores are otherwise called microspore tetrad. Now, each microspore would be undergoing divisions to develop into your pollen grain. Let's see how it is taking place. So we need to draw. We need to take one of these microspores first. Suppose this is our microspore we have taken with a nucleus. Now we know that there are layers called, there are wall layers with it. So there are certain layers which will be developing inside it. In this microspore, an inner layer would be developed, as well as an outside layer will also be developing. Outside layer will also be developing. See, outside layer has also been developed. So we can say a microspore upon differentiation will give rise to two layers. So the inner layer would be called your intyme, and the outer layer would be called exyme. And this spacing, there are certain spaces between the outer layers. There is certain space. So these spaces would be containing your germ pores. Okay? So this developed structure is now called pollen grain. This developed structure is now called pollen grain. So we can say the pollen grain consists of two layers. Inside layer is called intyme, outside layer is called exyme. Exyme is having a very good property. We can say exyme is made up of a material called sporopollenin. It's a highly resistant material. It can withstand high temperature and it can withstand high pressure, and any strong acid cannot break it. These are the three important features of this sporopollenin, which is making the pollen grain to keep the inside developing gametophyte intact, and it is not being affected by any high temperature, pressure or any strong acids. Till now no such element has been discovered which can break this layer or degrade this layer. Okay, so function of exyme you know, it's protection. Function of intyme is it would be developing into the layer of the germinating gametophyte, and this germ pore would be developing into a pollen tube. Germ pore function is to develop into a pollen tube. This is your pollen tube, and this nucleus will be differentiated to give rise to two nuclei. That is what? These are the two male gametes. rise to a structure called pollen tube, and the intine with the nucleus will be dividing or differentiating into two male gametes. But how that is taking place, that we need to know now. So see, this is the pollen grain which we have taken. So we are going to draw the pollen grain again. This is the pollen grain. This is the structure of the pollen grain from the microspore which you have taken. These are the intine. Sorry, the exine. And the dotted one is your what? Your the red line, that is intine. Now what will happen? First mitotic division will take place. Why mitotic? Because it's a haploid cell and it's a non-germinal cell. That means it's a somatic cell. So mitotic division. Why mitotic division is taking place? Mitotic division is taking place only to increase the number of cells inside this. This protecting layer is there, that is the exine is there to protect the inside content. So what we will do now, we will start dividing the cell into two. Mitosis will be giving rise to two cells. So out of the two cells, one would be a larger cell and the other would be a smaller cell. And since these would be two cells, they would be having two nuclei also. So one large vegetative cell and the smaller one would be called your generative cell. So mitotic division, the inside content is getting divided into two cells. What are the name of two cells? Vegetative cell and the other one is generative cell. Now, the vegetative cell is very very big and it will not allow the generative cell to withstand like that. So what it would do is, in the next step, when the vegetative cell is still growing, it will engulf the whole generative cell. That means this was the intine layer and this was your vegetative cell. Now this generative cell has been eaten up by the vegetative cell. But since this cell has its own existence, it will exert pressure on the walls of the vegetative cell. What will happen then? The vegetative cell cannot withstand the pressure exerted by the generative cell and it will burst out. So this was the intine layer. So now again the vegetative cell would be separated with a independent existence of the generative cell. Why the vegetative cell and generative cell are fighting among each other and having independent existence is that when this generative cell would be accounting for a completely new cell, then only it can develop into a new cell. So this generative cell would be developing into two male gametes, and this portion was having your germ pore. So that germ pore would be acting over here between the exine layers. It would be there. This can be called as your germ pore, which is attached to the exine layer as well as the intine. And when the generative cell will be keeping in contact with this, this germ pore would be developing into what? Pollen tube. So now the generative cell has differentiated completely and now the germ pore has started growing into pollen tube. So now we have ended up with two male gametes, and this is what the developed form of the germ pole. Okay, so this two male gametes we have got. So that is the end of this pre-fertilization event of the first structure, that is stamen. That is the male reproductive unit or male gametophyte is ready now. We need to go for the second one, that is the female gametophyte, which needs to be kept ready so that we can go for the next stage. So that's all for today's class. We will be heading towards the next part of it, that we will be starting with pistil, megasporogenesis, as well as development of embryo sac, that is called female gametophyte. So we are going to study in the next video about the structure of pistil, then megasporogenesis and embryo sac. So in today's video, what we talked about? We talked about, as you can refer your NCERT books under the headings pre-fertilization events, stamen, microsporogenesis, as well as pollen grains. Directly you can refer your NCERT for further reference. What would be given in the heading? Pre-fertilization events, structure and events, under the headings stamen, microsporogenesis, pollen grains. So we ended up with the structure of pollen grain giving rise to two male gametes. That means our male gamete is ready to take part in fertilization process. So just wait for the next video in which we will be taking up pistil, megasporogenesis and embryo sac. Thank you.